what I'm doing, Link, I got the shoe hot and I brushed it off with a slag brush for the fairies. It's never put this on. And then that way it cleans the metal. And plus, I like the borax simply because it will hold the borium on good. Let me get that booger right here. That forge is on, so it's hard. And you're going to put that the same. You're going to put a piece of this on each toe. Now what I'm doing, I've got it where let it stick a little. See, it still hadn't stick good. And they've got called a bullet. It's a round thing. I don't have any, but it sets on there a lot better than this. You got to be so level with this stuff to get it to stick on there. I want to show, the part I want to show is how it will look if it's going to stay on. Because a lot of guys will put it on and it comes off and they wonder why, and I'll show you how to tell if it's going to stay on there. So what we're going to do, we're going to take a break with you right now. You got to watch. As soon as you see it running, you want to get it, because if you let it run too long, it's going to run off the metal weave. So you want it to run just enough to where you can see the gold. And then you can tap it down. Now we're only going to do one piece here. We're not going to put it all over the shoe. Now let me cut this forge off. And what you can do, you can see, now I'm going to cool this, and you can see the gold on the shoe. And if you can't see the gold on the shoe, it ain't going to stay on. The gold, I call it the gold because it's a brazing rod, and it's a gold color. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to clean it and brush it, and you can actually see, you ain't going to knock that off. But if you cannot see that gold on the shoe, it will not stay on. So, and this right here is just as good as the screw ends. Well, except you ain't going to get it off, and you're going to have something in your trailer. Because believe me, gang, this will eat a trailer up. So hang in there, and we're going to be right back. We'll brush this thing, cool it off, brush it down, and I'll show you how it looks. All right, now what we've got here, Link, if you look close, and this, I think it's very important that every farrier, a lot of guys just don't know how to do this with a forge. But now I cleaned the shoe, brushed it off, put a little borax on it, and you can actually see the gold around on the steel there. And these little rugged looking places is actually the tungsten, and so that you ain't going to knock it off with a hammer. Now you can get this in a medium, a fine, or a coarse. This is coarse, and I like the big coarse if I'm going up into some real rugged, rocky country, because I'll tell you what, you ain't going to slip and slide. But you want a spot here, spot here, spot here, and a spot, so you want four spots there. Okay, so let's take another look, Link, at this trip you were on. And you were back in some pretty rugged country here. Mm-hmm. So if you got any pointers for people, and I wanted to send this, I'm gonna show it on our regular TV show, but I'm gonna send this to a lot of the outdoor shows, because safety, I think, with horses, and of course, you know, we're not gonna show them how to handle a horse. They got plenty of the guys out there, the riggers and that takes people in hunting and to use horses. But the thing about it, if I was going on a ride, I believe I'd ask the person, the horse I'm going to ride, I'm definitely going to have some traction devices other than heel caulks. So there is a difference, and I want to show that one more time to the gang out there. What heel caulks? Those are just pieces of steel that's poofed up there on the end of the shoe. That will not give you traction in rough country on slate rock or anything. It'll slide rock. In fact, it gives you less traction. That's for ground-to-ground going into the ground traction. So it ain't going to go into a rock. So remember that, gang, when you're riding. So let's take another look at some rugged country. The Link's out there riding, and we hope you enjoy it. And we made these films space for the outdoor where when you go out, you'll be safe on horses. Because after all, here at the National Ferry Research Center, that's one thing we do. We do a lot of research, and we've did a heck of a lot on traction devices to keep you, the rider, safe. And we'll see you right here next week on Horseshoeing Time. Let's take another look at some of the rugged country old Link's out there hunting in. Link, you're going to tell us a little bit about who all did you have with us, sir?
Well, in this particular film, it was just me, myself, being filmed at the start of the ride. I actually ended up going about 10 miles back into the woods.
Well, what was you on, deer?
Yeah, just deer.
Do you have problems when you're out there hunting with a deer? Do you go in, is this, you worry about people shooting you off the horse, or do you actually, when you got out there, you actually put on some camouflage? Or did you actually put on some orange where you could be seen?
Once I get fairly into the woods, I'll put on some orange, because you never know, somebody might be out there and think the horse is just one big deer.
You think this is going to be a new thing, but I know out west they hunt with horses, especially elk hunting and so on, trying to pack these animals out of the woods, and you've been out there hunting. Do you highly recommend traction devices? How many times, and I know you're my son, but I also know you do a lot more hunting than I do. So a lot of those guys are actually slipping and falling?
A lot of them really are, and especially the ones with me, because some people, they don't really get the big picture about the, you really do need traction on rocks and up in the mountains.
So the individuals that are not a real horseman, they, a lot of times they're hunters and they ain't never been on a horse much, and they get out there and the horse starts slipping and sliding, they get spooked, they're ready to get off of that booger.
Exactly.
All right, gang, it's been great. We'll see you right here next week on Horseshoe in Time. Remember this, hey, happy horse
makes a happy owner.
We'll see you next week right here on Horseshoe in Time.